it's kind of
Well, it's the Portugality shut for 2 years. Shut in April, open again 2011. We had the opportunity to use this space. Brought a load of artists from around the country together, mostly working street art and graffiti art, to create their version of the Scottish psyche, referencing the murals that are upstairs in the gallery. And we've been installing it for 4 weeks, and we're opening tonight. That's about it. And I've no had any sleep. there's a lot of folk from Dundee, used to live and work in Dundee, so there's quite a lot of Dundonian artists from Edinburgh, Glasgow, Tane, Inverness, Ayrshire, around Scotland. Some of them are art graduates, some of them haven't been to art school, some of them are going to art school, some of them are just people that make things, you know, so it's a good wee collection of different disciplines, different people. Yeah, go for it. We've got a band on just now, so. Fantastic musicians, and they're just getting into the whole spirit of the collaborative nature of the exhibition. Because people are painting on top of each other and around each other, working, reacting to the space. That's what they're doing as well, so it's all bra.
My name's Jan Sesnick. I did the UV LED button spray paint can things. So you just have the little boxes and jars full of little UV LEDs. You press the button, you go up to the wall, and you can kind of do temporary spray paint stuff. And it's so it glows the wall. It's really cool.
Well, this is the future of the Scottish National Portrait Gallery as it transforms itself. This is for everybody who has never been to the Scottish National Portrait Gallery before. We've got work that is internationally exciting, and it's all happening at a time when Edinburgh is the focus of the world's attention. So it's a great step forward for the National Galleries, and we hope that it inspires lots of people to come here for the first time.
Managed to
squeeze wee bits in everywhere else as well for each other. So.
Yeah. It's been good fun.
I got involved through Richie Cumming, who is the curator. I've known him for quite a while and I've always painted with him because he's a graffiti artist as well. He's done street art himself, so basically he'd seen my stuff and we'd worked together on numerous occasions. So like he's like, oh, I've got this project for the gallery, which is closing for renovation, so we're going to try and get something organised for the festival, which is good. He got us in because we do like large-scale portraiture work. And it kind of fits, maybe fits quite well into the portrait gallery, and all the other, some of the other artists deal with slightly different, more abstract kind of work. So it was good to get really large scale portraiture in. I think that's why he got me and the guy that I work with, Martin, involved as well. We've been doing like 19 hour days, 20 hour days for especially the last week, and before that it was 15, 16 hours a day for 3 weeks. So like, and we're not really getting paid, so it's like a huge, huge amount of work, huge amount of hours for a show. So, but I think you can see that. Some of the security were on our side, and some of the other security were a bit kind of, well, what are these guys doing here? Especially there was a little bit of an incident. Like halfway through, I don't really want to talk about it, but like I kind of divided the warden staff a little bit. So, but in the end, the directors of the portrait gallery and all the really important people were 100% behind us. So,
what do you think of this exhibition that's happening?
Well, it's absolutely brilliant. Yeah. Absolutely brilliant. Yes, it's good. The amount of work artists put into it, they put a hell of a work into that exhibition. And it is good to see young artists get a chance like that. The way they work with the floor and that, I mean, and the walls, because the place is getting ripped apart after this exhibition. You'll never ever get that again in any of the galleries.